I read it from 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 17 through 20. Because they have forsaken me and made offerings to other gods, that they may provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore my wrath will be kindled against this place, and will not be quenched. But to the king of Judah, who sent you to inquire of the Lord, thus shall you say to him, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, regarding the words that you have heard, because your heart was penitent, and you humbled yourself before the Lord, when you heard how I spoke against this place, against the inhabitants, that they should become desolate and a curse, and you tore your clothes, and you wept before me. I also have heard you, declares the Lord. Therefore, behold, I will gather you to your fathers. You shall be gathered to your graves in peace, and your eyes shall not see disaster that will bring upon this place. And they brought back the word to the king. Well, Hosea was a good king. Even though he became a king at a young age, he trusted in God. He loved God more than anything. And he brought back the word of God. And because he repented, the disaster for Jerusalem was spared for a few more years. No matter what, God would always do what he says he would do. Sometimes he gives us longer than we think we deserve. But there's always hope. And there's hope for our country, too. No matter how far we have gone from God, God is still there. There is repentance, but there's also a price sometimes, too. No matter what, God will always take care of us. And he loves us so much. So no matter what, trust in God, and he will take care of us. Repent. There's always repentance. There's nothing we can't do without repentance. Sometimes you have to pay the consequences of that repentance, you know. Sometimes if you kill someone, you still can repent. But there is a consequence to it. If there's a death penalty, you have to die. But there's heaven, too, so. Whatever. God is good. Just trust in God. And he will take care of you. And keep praying for our country. It needs lots of prayers. And president, too. Thank you so much.